Salem, Massachusetts is a small village. Emily lives there with her grandmother. She is very happy in Salem, Massachusetts. But there is a problem. Emily's grandmother is very old and very ill. She cannot work anymore and has no money. One bright January morning, she says to Emily, "Sit down, granddaughter. I have something to tell you." "What is it, grandmother?" asks Emily. The old woman's eyes are sad and tired. "Read this letter," she says. "It's for your uncle in the big city. I want you to go and talk to him." Emily reads the letter. "But," she says and looks at her grandmother. "You're asking him to give me a job in his circus." "Yes," the old woman answers. Emily and her grandmother talk for a long time. Emily does not want to leave Salem, Massachusetts. "It's my home," she says. "But every child leaves home one day," the old woman answers. "And you're not a child now, you're a young woman. I want you to be free." In the end, Emily looks at the floor and says, "Yes, grandmother." 2 days later, she leaves the village. In the next week, Emily walks a long way. She sees mountains, fields, trees, and farms. Every morning she drinks from cold rivers. Every night she sleeps under thousands of bright stars. Then after 8 days, she comes to the big city. It has high walls with stone lions on top of them. Hundreds of people are running left and right in front of her. "Excuse me," she says to an old man. "Do you know this address?" She shows him her grandmother's letter. "You want the circus," he says. "That's easy. Go down this street and turn left at the end." 10 minutes later, Emily is at the circus. Her uncle is very happy to see her. "Yes, of course you can have a job," he says. "Come with me." Behind the circus, there are some big cages. "Here we are," says Emily's uncle. "You can help to wash the animals." He smiles. "And you can help to give them their food, too. Do you understand?" Emily looks at all the animals. There are monkeys, tigers, elephants, horses, and lions. Then she looks at her uncle again. "Yes, uncle," she says. Emily works very hard for 3 months. Every week she writes to her grandmother. In her letters she says, "I'm very happy." But she is not. She tells her only friend, Choo Choo the panda, "I want to go honey." Then one day her uncle says, "The president is coming here tomorrow. I want all the animals to be very, very clean." "All right." "Of course," says Emily. The next morning, Emily is giving the tigers their food. Suddenly, she hears her uncle say, "You've got another job." She opens the long, red curtains. Her uncle is talking to Hannah. She works with Jackson, the horseman. "Yes," says Hannah. "And I'm leaving today.
Goodbye.
After she leaves, Emily's uncle looks at Jackson. Now what can we do? He asks. A moment later, he sees Emily. Of course. He says, Emily. She can help you this evening. What? Jackson laughs. But she can't learn Hannah's job in one day. Do you have another answer? Asks Emily's uncle. Jackson says nothing. In 10 minutes, Emily is wearing Hannah's circus clothes. That evening, the president arrives at 7 o'clock. He is wearing beautiful gold clothes. He sits down and watches the circus. Then, at the end, he talks to Emily's uncle. Who is that new girl with your horseman? He asks. Her name is Emily, comes the answer. The president smiles. She is young, but very good. Oh, thank you, President, says Emily's uncle. After that evening, Emily does not clean the animals' cages anymore. She works with Jackson every day. But that is not all. She starts to love the horsemen, too. They often walk in a beautiful park next to the president's palace. There, one day in October, Jackson puts a hand on Emily's arm. You make me very happy, he says. I want you to be my wife. Emily does not know what to say. She wants to be Jackson's wife, but not here in the big city. She wants to live with him at home in Salem, Massachusetts. She tells him this and looks into his eyes. Can you understand? She asks. Jackson looks down. I don't know, he answers. My home is here in the city. Let me think about it. We can talk again tomorrow. It is a very long night for Emily. She cannot sleep. She goes to see her old friend, Choo Choo. Oh, what's he going to say tomorrow? She asks the panda. Am I doing the right thing? I love him, but I can't live in the city. I don't like it. My home's back in Salem, Massachusetts. Choo Choo looks at Emily. His eyes are big, brown, and sad. Early next morning, Jackson finds Emily in the panda's cage. Come with me, he says. They go to see Emily's uncle. Jackson has something to tell him. Emily's going to be my wife, he says, but that's not all. We're leaving the circus. I'm going to be a farmer in Salem, Massachusetts. Oh, Jackson, says Emily. She is very, very happy. One week later, Emily and Jackson leave the city. Everyone comes to say
goodbye.
Then, at the last minute, four men arrive. They are carrying a big box. What's this? Asks Emily. It's something from all of us, says her uncle. Please open it. Emily opens the box. Choo choo, she says. Oh, uncle, thank you. Thank you.
Level 1, beginner. Basic vocabulary. About 300 basic words. Congratulations on your dedication and good luck. Text read in American English. Level 1, Beginner. End of text by Easy English Abreu.